Let's pretend that you work for a government agency and you're asked to develop a program that will change people's behaviors related to climate change. So immediately you might feel overwhelmed. Changing people's behaviors is not easy, and neither is knowing what behaviors will best mitigate climate change. There's no one way to address problems like changing environmental behaviors or reducing global warming. But researchers and policymakers tend to agree about a process for addressing these and other so-called wicked problems. This process involves working across academic disciplines, like psychology and natural resources management, and also across organizations, including government, agencies, NGOs, and community-based organizations. We refer to the process of working across disciplinary silos and across organizational boundaries as transdisciplinary approaches. Working across disciplines can be challenging in itself. We have to learn new terms and learn to respect different research traditions. For example, ecosystem scientists rely heavily on quantitative data about soils, plants, and animals, whereas environmental educators use not only quantitative surveys to, for example, gauge impacts of their programs on people's behaviors, but also qualitative methods like open-ended interviews and observations of programs. An ecosystem scientist in my department at Cornell, and our department includes both ecosystem and social scientists, once said publicly in a department meeting that anything social scientists find out in the research was already obvious to him. To dismiss other people's work offhand is not a very productive attitude in trying to work across disciplines. Listening and trying to understand diverse approaches is critical in work that crosses disciplinary silos to address wicked problems. Crossing organizational boundaries can present even greater challenges. Say that you work in a government agency that issues top-down policy directives, but you realize that there's too much political opposition to putting climate change policies into place. So you decide to try community-based approaches. You might experience frustration with the slowness and the inefficiency of holding stakeholder meetings, and with the notion that instead of developing and enforcing a single policy, you're going to have to try out several alternative approaches and see what works best, all the while adapting as you go along. And you'll need to respect the knowledge of non-expert community members who may not have formal training, but whose local perspectives and experiential knowledge can be invaluable in addressing wicked problems. You can think of the challenges of crossing organizational boundaries in this way. So you might be used to approaches that resemble throwing a stone. You have control and you can determine what direction the stone is going. But transdisciplinary work is more like throwing out a flock of birds. The trajectory is far less predictable, and you have to adapt constantly to constantly changing conditions. But on the positive side, including multiple disciplines and the voices of multiple organizations and stakeholders, can result in ideas and even innovative practices, both of which are desperately needed in addressing wicked problems. After all, these problems wouldn't be easy if there were an easy solution that one person could simply dictate. So what skills are needed to do transdisciplinary work? Three skills are particularly important. First is big picture thinking, also called systems thinking. This means being able to see the whole problem, including how the various components and solutions interact. So for example, not assuming that the way to change climate related behaviors is simply you explaining the science of climate change. Research has shown that a cultural conservative who listens to a liberal talk about climate science may simply dismiss the science because of the messenger. She may even decide to write her congressman about the need to protect the economy against left-wing ideas that interfere with individual rights. So it's critical to consider the scientific as well as psychological, cultural, and other aspects of the problem and how they may impact each other. So second is being able to connect with others. It goes without saying that listening to ideas from those in your agency, from those in NGOs and community organizations, and from stakeholders is critical in transdisciplinary work. And finally, being flexible and able to adapt as new stakeholders become engaged and as new ideas for practices are revealed and implemented, and as new results of the practices come to light, which suggests modifications of the practice to better achieve the common goal. This can mean giving up control and considering solutions proposed by others. This also entails tolerating uncertainty, while keeping your eyes on the prize. That is, not getting discouraged by programs that don't go perfectly, but working to improve them while remembering the long-term goal or problem that you are trying to address. In short, systems thinking, connecting with others, and being adaptable are critical skills in transdisciplinary work. And transdisciplinary approaches are an important means of addressing wicked problems like changing behaviors and climate change.